I come up with no introduction.
Oh, Steve Raymer!
Hi, Steve Raymer, Director of the Maintenance Division. I meant that about Mike. And Cliff, that was a hell of an explanation of exactly what the economic package was about. That was impressive. And that leads it to the rest of us to put everything together regarding the work rules and the, just how do you get this work back in? What's that going to be about? But first, let me just make a couple of general comments. The NTFTs, their new acronym, non-traditional full-time, doesn't apply to grievance practice. It works really well, as the directors will explain, you know, for their crafts and for their purposes, what they have to do to grow their end of it. Our staffing is based on 760 hours a year, 5 8-hour days. Whether the office is open or closed is kind of irrelevant. But everything from stripping and waxing the floor, in any office, but in a semi-line, it's an associate office, doing our preventive maintenance routes, and machines have to be off, so it's closed. That's almost good for us. Our office is open, we're there to meet you. The mail volume doesn't affect our work, except the more mail volume there is, the more equipment gets used, the level of maintenance that has to be done on this and that, so it doesn't work out. But it doesn't affect work duties on this work hours. So we kept where we were with the traditional, our traditional rules and procedures on staff. So what I did was take all the slides out and just put in the main things here. Just a summary of changes that you all see when you get the contact mailed out to you to look at. And I'll skip through few of them. The top two are essentially housekeeping type issues, things that should have happened, had been misunderstood. 3J, I got to tell you my short story, I guess. That was the interesting one. Every craft's got tiebreakers. The tiebreakers for seniority. You get two people hired in on the craft or come into your craft on the same day. Last contract in 06, the APWU, the maintenance division, put forth streamlining our articles so it was more easy to read. And we said, all we want to say is whenever there's a tie, here's the list to go down until you break the tie. Postal Service resisted and insisted we copy language that already existed in a prior Q&A. We said, okay, fine. So they put six sentences of stuff in there. We knew what it meant, what the intent was, but that's the way it was. So what they did was they came forward with their proposal this time, insisting that we streamline the process and that we should say, here's our list of tiebreakers, apply them all to the tiebreakers.